More than just a chip builder, Intel is a brain trust with labs all over the world exploring new ideas. The company showed off many of these ideas on Wednesday at Research at Intel Day, held at the Computer History Museum in Mountain View, California. One project at Intel's Seattle labs is called Oasis and could make any surface into a computing surface. It uses projectors and 3D cameras to recognize objects, detect gestures, and display icons. Oasis can turn things like kitchen counters into broad user interfaces like Microsoft's Surface tabletop touchscreen, but at a fraction of the cost, Intel says. It's also working on messy surfaces handy for cooking. Researcher Beverly Harrison demonstrated Oasis on a mock-up of a home kitchen with plastic food items.
In the Oasis project, we're looking at 3D real-time object recognition and 3D real-time gesture recognition with everyday objects, everyday surfaces, and very naturalistic interaction to create these islands of interactivity in home environments. So there's nothing special about the countertops, the objects, or my hands. There's no markers or barcodes that we're using to do this recognition, and it can be on any surface in your home. Our system relies on recognizing features from an object, like its shape, color, or texture, and your hand, the hand shapes and colors, and we can interact live with these objects and systems to apply menu functions and virtual actions to anything in your everyday environment. For example, I can look up recipes that relate specifically to steak and filter those out. Or I can save recipes in a virtual drawer in my kitchen that I can later access and use.
In the kitchen example, Oasis also helped to modify a shopping list. The system could deliver information relevant to any type of object it recognized. For pills on a bathroom counter, it could show when the user will need to order a prescription refill. Tapping on an item out of the refrigerator might show whether it's been there too long. Using fake spilled coffee, Intel also came up with another warning. With reporting by Stephen Lawson in Mountain View, California, I'm Nick Barber, IDG News Service.